Evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Delhi, I welcome you to the three-day festival of Indian classical music and dance, a Sangeet Samaroh organized to commemorate the foundation day of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. As many of you know, the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan was founded by Kulapati K.M. Munshi on 7th November 1938. As an adventure in faith, a faith in India's past, present and future. Over the years, from being a modest institution dedicated to Indological research, it has steadily grown into a comprehensive, cooperative, apolitical movement, a national movement with an international outlook. It seeks to promote a value-based life with ethical and spiritual values pervading the very essence of daily life. Founded with the blessings of the Mahatma Gandhi, this institution has grown into an institution of national eminence, an institute of excellence with a pan-Indian presence. Today, it has 120 centers within India and 7 centers overseas. It has been honored by the Rajiv Gandhi Award for National Integration in 1992, the Communal Harmony Award in 1999, and the International Gandhi Peace Prize 2002. To commemorate its foundation, it has been decided that henceforth, as an annual event, the Bhavan Sangeet Samaroh will be organized on the 6th, 7th and 8th of November every year. This long journey to celebrate excellence in the Indian classical arts starts with this year. What is special about this year is that during this year's festival, we pay tribute to three great musicians who passed away earlier this year, namely Ustad Ali Akbar Khan, the great Sarod Maestro, Srimati Gangubai Hangal, Hindustani classical vocalist of eminence, and Srimati D.K. Pattamal, preeminent artist of Carnatic music. We would like to commence the proceedings today by requesting the chairman of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Mr. Chinmay Gare Khan, the director of the Delhi Kendra, Mr. J. Veeraraghavan, and the advisor for the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Delhi, Mr. Ashok Pradhan, to please come onto the stage and light the ceremonial lamp. May I request our first artist, Sri Parthadas, to join these dignitaries on stage as they light the ceremonial lamp. Ladies and gentlemen, at the moment of the lighting of the lamp, there will be the Mangalacharan, the auspicious utterances. These will be under the guidance of Dr. Rabindranath, Principal Sanskrit Vidyalaya, Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, and will be conducted by the students.
ಸ್ಥಿರೈರಂಗೈ ಸೃಷ್ಟುವ ಗುಪ್ಸಸ್ತನು ಹಿರ್ಯಶೆ ಮಹಿ ದೇವಹಿತಂ ಜದಾಯುಃ. ಓಂ ಸರ್ವೇ ಭವಂತು ಸುಖಿನಃ, ಸರ್ವೇ ಸಂತು ನಿರಾಮಯಃ, ಸರ್ವೇ ಭದ್ರಾಣಿ ಪಶ್ಯಂತು, ಮಾ ಕಶ್ಚಿತ್ ದುಃಖಭಾಗ್ ಭವೇತ್. ಅಸತೋ ಮಾ ಸದ್ಗಮಯ, ತಮಸೋ ಮಾ ಜ್ಯೋತಿರ್ಗಮಯ, ಮೃತ್ಯೋರ್ಮಾ ಅಮೃತಂ ಗಮಯ. ಓಂ ಶಾಂತಿ ಶಾಂತಿ ಶಾಂತಿ.
With the environment having become sacred with these chantings, may I now request Sri Chinmaya Garikhan to please govern the portrait of Kulapati K.M. Munshi and offer floral tribute to the portrait of Ustad Ali Akbar Khan. Part in Indian music and dance. Not coming out of a system of notating music or having written music, all creativity in the classical arts of music and dance is born of instant creation. As such, even the act of paying homage to the memory of great musicians allows us to recall their brilliance, their uniqueness, their entire palim and their repertoire. The three-day program, Sangeet Samaroh of the Bhavan, is dedicated to the memory of three such great artists, Ustad Ali Akbar Khan Sahab, Gangubhai Hadgal, and D.K. Patel. Paying a musical tribute on behalf of the Bhavan to these three great giants who once trod this earth and have left now their memories behind to serve as an oil in the continuing lamp of Indian classical music and dance is Shri Partha Das. A musician of many dimensions, he is a soloist sensitive to the nuance of his instrument, the sitar. He spent his early years at the Ali Akbar College of Music, Calcutta, learning sitar from Ustad Bahadur Hussain Khan, Ustad Ali Akbar Khan himself, and Professor Nikhil Banerjee. Later, he spent 6 years under the tutelage of Professor Santosh Kumar Banerjee of the Rabindra Bharati University. He has been associated for many years because of the brilliance of his compositions with institutions like the Bharati Kala Kendra, the Kathak Kendra, and now for several years with the Bharati Vidya Bhavan. His virtuosity in this field gives him a special identity. His reverence for the classical and his adaptability to new sounds allow for knowledgeable creativity. Today, accompanied by Pandit Vinod Pathak and Ustad Akram Khan on the tabla, he will present his musical Shradhanjali. Accompanying him is Mohsin Ali Khan, his disciple. The artists will be welcomed on this occasion in a traditional manner with chandan and mishri. And applying the chandan and offering the mishri will be two young students, Dibanjali Nag and Sharanya Chhabi. Parthadas, Ustad Akram Khan, Pandit Vinod Pathak, Sh. Shri Mohsin Ali. Ladies and gentlemen, the music tribute by Shri Prabhupada's. Thank you.
नमस्कार। मैं सर्वोत्तम शास्त्र बजाता हूँ। दिस इज नॉट माई इंस्ट्रूमेंट एक्चुअली, बट टू प्ले ट्रिब्यूट टू माय स्कल एक्नॉलेज लिटिल बिट फाइव मिनट्स सो नाउ विल प्ले सिमर विल प्ले रा पुरिया धनासी composed in the memory of my late guru, Ustad Rehbul Khan Sahib. This tala is namely Lavak Rahi. Lavak Rahi in 16 beats and one new style of that in the name of late Ustad Rehbul Khan Sahib, last ancestor of Tan Singh Nirvana, Singh Nirvana. Please listen to this, if you like it, it's okay. The name of the tala is Navagrahi. The word is Dha, Dhin, Ta. Ti, Ke, Ka, Ta, Ga, Ni, Ga, Na. Dha, Ni, Na, Ka. Dha, Ni, Na, Ka. Dha, Ni, Na, Ka. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.